الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت، ذي العزة والجبروت، الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام، عزيز لا يضام، قهار لا يرام، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Or you will believe, fear Allah as he should be feared, and die not except in the state of Islam. For may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most merciful bestow upon us the gift to die on the state of Islam. Allahumma ameena ya rabbal alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us in these last 10 days to be the nearest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with our invocation and our sujood. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to free us all from the doom of the hellfire in these blessed days of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Hadid, and presenting in a way his greatness subhanahu wa ta'ala, يُعَرِّفُ نَفْسَهُ لِعِبَادِهِ, he making his servant to know him. قَالَ هُوَ الْأَوَّلُ وَالْآخِرُ وَالظَّاهِرُ وَالْبَاطِنُ وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ. هو الأول is the first, والآخر the last, والظاهر he the evident, the manifest, the most high, والباطن the immanent, the hidden, and also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as الباطن called the hidden, but also the nearest to everything, to anything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayat helps the believer to come to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, discover the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which will help as a condition for someone seeking to be nearer to Allah, seeking to be more into worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because one will not be able to connect with a person if they do not know to speak their language or do not know who are these people. Therefore, when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you do not know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how someone would be able to have devotion, how someone would be able to have focus, how someone would be able to have veneration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in a hadith that has mentioned in Sahih Muslim, narrated by Abi Huraira, that he used to say a dua when he go to his bed. And going to bed is someone who's submitting himself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because in the knowledge of Allah, he might not wake up the next day. So for among his dua, calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the creator of the heaven and the earth, as the one who owned the al-arsh al-azim, the tremendous throne. And then he's saying, Ya Allah, antal awwalu, you are the first. Qala la shay'a qablak, nothing is before you. Wa antal akhiru, Ya Allah, you are the last, nothing is be, there's after you. And Ya Allah, you are the most evident, you are al-zahiru, nothing is above you. And Ya Allah, you are the al-batin, nothing can be without you. And in a way, everything is standing by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this hadith, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explaining the meaning of al-awwal, wal-akhiru, wal-zahiru, wal-batinu, to help a believer. And the one who knows the most Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's the one who teaching us and instructing us to know closer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be near to Him. Because the most important for the believer, especially when we thinking about in these days and we have the opportunity to focus and we have the opportunity to reflect and ponder on our relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we cannot determine or review this relation if we first just contemplate on the greatness of Allah. Just to take these four names help us to understand the whole creation, help us to understand and have a true, ultimate truth about the creation or the universe that we live in. So when you say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the first, and this is like steps to contemplate And the Prophet ﷺ said, with me nothing is before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the evidence that the one is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one. So this is give you the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And not only the oneness of Allah, but also evidence on His greatness, evidence on His life, evidence on His absolute will, evidence on His absolute power, evidence on His absolute sovereignty subhanahu wa ta'ala. So He will awwal, which is mean anything goes back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when the heart looking and reflecting on the first, everything goes back to Allah and comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we think about al-akhiru, so the akhiru that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the last, nothing is after Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had the absolute will. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had the absolute power. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if He let things to exist, even the Jannah is by His will, not because the Jannah said, after You created me, You cannot undo me. Not because the believer will enter paradise and said, You cannot hear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing hath above Him, nothing hath after Him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the last. So if Allah the first and the last, then the whole time of the whole universe, of the whole cosmos, is the hand of Allah, the one who created the time. So when you are standing in the middle of this universe contemplating, and you look from the first to the end, there is only Allah. La ilaha illallah. Then when you're thinking about al-dhahiru wal-batinu, the Most High. The Most High is the one who has, subhanAllah, the management of the whole creation in His hand. The provision of the whole creation in His hand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala yudabbiru al-amra yufassilu al-ayati la'allakum biliqai rabbikum tuqinun. He's the one who's managing everything. He's the one who's planning and projecting and decreeing everything in full details, in the most infinite detail that only Allah knows, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows, that you may be certain of believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, inna samawati wal arda, Allah subhanahu inna Allah yumsiku samawati wal arda an tazula. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is holding the heaven and the earth lest they cease. In amsakahuma min ahadin ghayri, if there's anyone who will be able to hold the heaven and the earth in a place stable as we live today, is only Allah. So this is al-dhahiru, it's so manifest, it's so evident, but people, they could not, subhanAllah, realize that. So as some of the scholars say, it's so evident, it's so manifest, it's so apparent that you cannot see Him. It's like the example, like contemplating a beautiful landscape, but you're not aware that the light will help you to see it. If there is no light, you cannot see anything. So the light, Allah in this example, is the light, subhanAllah, the example to the landscape that we call mentioned, is like that light. We're seeing, we're living, we're walking, we're thinking, we're eating, but we do not know that under that, who the one, subhanAllah, managing everything is Allah. Now, al-batinu, al-batinu, which is means, subhanAllah, that nothing can has its essence, or nothing can, subhanAllah, exist, or can sustain itself only by Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَفَمَنْ هُوَ قَائِمٌ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ نَفْسٍ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ. He's the one who holding and taking care of every soul as it exists, and as it sustain itself, is by the will of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, you have the time from the end to the beginning is in the hand of Allah. And you have the space from the infinite far to the lowest or the farthest point in this cosmos is in the hand of Allah. Therefore, when the heart looks from light, left, up and down, contemplating into yourself, you'll find all the asbab, all the things that you do, you work to gain, you know, bread, you know, win your bread. You work and you study to get the thing. You have a family. You do things. All this asbab, all when you look in this mega vision, everything melts to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, when the believer standing, he has only Allah. That's the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he's going to his bed said, "Anta al-awwalu." والآخر والظاهر والباطن. Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه, when he was, you know, seeking to kill the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and that old lady, she told him, why you are looking for Muhammad? Go to your sister who already followed him, just to distract him to not find the way to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He went, Fatima ibn al-Khattab, and her husband is Sa'id ibn Zayd, and with them was Lord Khabbab ibn al-Arq. They were studying the Quran. When he came, he entered like he was, subhanAllah, Jabbar. He was like, you know, someone who's harsh. He hit his sister. How can you do this? And then after that, he calmed down and he requested to read what they were reading. She told him, no, I will not give you that till you go take a shower and clean yourself. He did, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Now the most amazing thing, what he had read, right after reading it, he asked for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this time not to terrorize the Prophet, but to accept Islam. What happened to Umar? In these names that make Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu to be shook, are this recitation of the Quran that make Umar to change in no time. Because reading such an amazing thing really make Umar to feel how weak he is, how, subhanAllah, dependent he is, how poor he is to the one who created him. He read the beginning of Surah Taha. And if you just reflect on Surah Taha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَلْ أَرْرَحْمَانُ عَلَى الْعَرْشِ اسْتَوَى. Something in his aboveness that someone cannot even imagine. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قَلْ لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا وَمَا تَحْتَ الثَّرَى. He has whatever in the heaven, whatever in the earth, whatever between them, and whatever under the ground. And Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, reading such a thing, he feel like every ayah he read, he gets smaller. As he was arrogant, entering, want to beat and to be harsh and to stop and to, subhanAllah, go against the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, every ayah he's reading it make him smaller, smaller, smaller. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he find himself this part of the creation. He's one of the less of the particle in this whole universe that belongs to who? To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he find himself, there is no way except to submit to the one who's speaking to him, because he said, وَإِن تَجَرْ بِالْقَوْرِ. It's like Allah addressing to you. If you disclose and you say loud what you have into your heart, so know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not only know what you're saying, but you know what you have a secret in your heart. And more than hidden of the secret is the secret that you do not have still, that you will have it in the future in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the greatness of Allah. That is the knowledge of Allah. That is how our relation should be with Allah. If Umar read few lines to change him and he want to accept Islam at that time, you know, right after reading this ayah. So when we look at these names to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to help us in these blessed, you know, days and nights to be closer to Allah, you're going to ask someone that everything in his hand. You're going to ask, everything has a beginning, and it has an end, and it has a dhahir, something that apparent in it, of above it, and it has something that is hidden, that is at his root. So if you look at ourselves, then everything comes, started with Allah, and everything is traveling to Allah, and everything is managed and created and, subhanAllah, sustained by Allah. And everything, it's his root, his essence, is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So wherever you turn, there is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart, in your way. فَأَيْنَمَا تُوَلُّ فَثَمَّ وَجْهُ اللَّهِ. For why someone making himself or herself small, to restrict themselves into this small dunya, into this very limitless, limit possibilities, things that they are orchestrated, managed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the nearest to you. When the company, they were traveling and everyone was screaming, Ya Allah, he said, قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ ارْبَعُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ. Just, you know, care about yourself. You are not calling, قَالَ إِنَّكُمْ لَا تَدْعُونَ أَصَمًّا وَلَا غَائِبًا. You're not calling someone who's deaf and someone who's absent. You are calling As-Sami'u al-Qareeb, the all-hearing subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most near. قَالَ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَأَقْرَبُ لِأَحَدِكُمْ مِنْ عُنِقِ رَاحِلَتِهِ. Allah is closer to you, closer to you, to the companion, the one Allah, than to you, than you to the neck of your camel, of your ride that you are mounting. So when you're thinking about that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala khala, and we have created man, and we are closer to him, nearer to him than his jugular vein. So here, how when you think about it, wherever you look, whatever you think, wherever you ponder, is Allah is around you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the power of everything. So He is the nearest to you. When you say Al-Awwal wal-Akhir wal-Zahir wal-Batin, the nearest to you is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the meaning of Al-Batin, as the Salaf, they explained it. Qala an yakun subhanallah la shay'a aqrabu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, la shay'a, there is nothing that is closer to anything, but Allah is closer to it. So whenever you think of it, that you are close to you, know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is closer to you, is nearer to you subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now the question is, how near you are from Allah? Because our Salaf, rahimahumullah ta'ala, like Al-Imam Al-Junayd, he said, if we try to implement this name is on our life, then we find Al-Awwal, the first, Bisharh Al-Qulub. He started by expanding your chest to Islam. The last, by Maghfirat Al-Dunub, and he will ending by forgiving your sins. And the Most High, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the one that He's providing you from everything subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has the knowledge of everything. Then you trust and you rely on such a knowledge, and you know that He is the all-wise subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as the hidden part is kashfu al-kurub, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the relief in time of difficulties. Al-Imam al-Saddi, he said something beautiful. He said, al-awwalu, for me as an interpretation, qala awwalun bibirrihi idh arrafaka bitawheedihi. He the first, by his birr, by his kindness, by his loving kindness, that he guide you to his oneness subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْآخِرُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى بِجُودِهِ, and he is the last, by his generosity, by his favor upon you, that he showed you the path to repentance. قَالَ وَالظَّاهِرُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى, the Most High, the one who has the whole knowledge, the one who has your Rabb, the most caring. قَالَ بِتَوْفِيقِهِ, by he help you and make easy for you to make sujood to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْبَاطِنُ, the most hidden, that he subhanallah helping you in the most hidden way. قَالْ بِسِتْرِهِ, that he cover all your sins that you have done behind closed doors. So see, this is subhanallah how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is near to you. And then when you think about it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us that Salih alayhi salam said to his people, إِنَّ رَبِّي قَرِيبٌ مُجِيبٌ, Allah is near and responsive. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaching him toward the end of Saba, قَالَ إِنَّ رَبِّي سَمِيعٌ قَرِيبٌ, He's the one who hears and near. So knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is near to you, what is then your relation with Allah? Why are you not that near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because when you understand and you make dua, you said, Ya Allah, you are Al-Awwalu. So nothing that you had in the past or you are living in the present, but it was in the knowledge of Allah, orchestrated in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And nothing in the end, and nothing that between is also in the hand of Allah. So when you look at it, then safeguard Allah to find all the safeguarding from Him. Then ask Allah for help and rely on Allah because He's the nearest to you subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are we implementing such a thing? Because in Ramadan, especially in these days, if we do not review our relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to really renew our oath with Allah, which is the requirement in Ramadan. In Ramadan, you have to renew the oath. You have signed the contract with Allah, a contract called the contract of belief, a contract of exchange that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you in exchange of your iman, of your devotion. He'll give you the Jannah that He prepared and He created to his righteous servant subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, when you think and you look at the Quran and you see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was near to his servant. He was near to the fire that has been lit to burn Ibrahim than the people who made this fire. قَالُوا حَرِّقُوهُ وَانْصُرُوا أَلِهَتَكُمْ, burn him. And حَرِّقُوهُ subhanallah is like, not only burn him like بِصِفَةِ الْمُبَالَغَةِ, with a superlative, like burn him to the bone, if you can say. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He was nearer to Ibrahim and nearer to the fire than the people who made the fire. He said, Ya Naru, Allah called it, Kuni Bardan wa Salaman ala Ibrahim. That's how Allah will be near to you when you need Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was nearer to Ismail than the blade that his father Ibrahim put on his neck. Because Ibrahim alayhi salam, he started to cut the neck. He started. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was nearer to Ismail that blade. قَالَ لَقَدْ صَدَّقْتَ رُؤْيَا. Stop. It's not going to work. It's not going to work. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is near. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was near to Yunus than the stomach of or the belly of the fish, of the whale. Because if you let Yunus subhanallah and you let the stomach to act in its normal way, it will have digested Yusuf. So to break it down, subhanallah, will smash it. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He preserved Yunus in a place where everything subhanallah is decomposed. He was nearer to Yunus than where the space that he was in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was nearer to Musa and Harun than the tyrant Fir'aun, because they said, قَالَ رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا نَخَافُ أَن يَفْرُطَ عَلَيْنَا أَوْ يَفْرُطَ. We don't know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to go overboard. He's going to kill us in no time. قَالَ لَا تَخَافَ. Do not be feared. I'm with you. I smell wa ara. I hear and I see. He was nearer. He was with them. That's what we miss in our relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was nearer to Yusuf than his brother who threw him in the well. Because he inspired to him, he said, don't worry. There's going to come a time that you're going to say such a thing. This is, you're going to relate this event to your brother and you, then they will be not knowing you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was nearer to the heart of Musa than the fear that subhanallah came, that expression of fear. When Musa alayhi salam, you see him confident in front of the sorcerer, and all the sorcerer, they were throwing their sticks and their ropes and they turn into the snakes. And Musa alayhi salam seeing them really snakes, despite the fact he looked confident, but there's fear inside. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was closer to his heart than fear. قَالَ فَأَوْجَسَ فِي نَفْسِهِ خِيفَةً. This fear came subhanallah into his heart. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَا تَخَفْ. Do not fear. You are the highest. I am near. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling you, I'm near to you. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. When my servant asks you about me, I'm indeed near to them. I listen to their dua. I listen to their request. I listen to their invocation. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the nearest to you, where are you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is very important to reflect, because we engage in the dua without first reviewing our relation. Allah is near to you. Are you near to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala? He showed us that the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who are calling upon, you know, beside Allah, قَالَ أُولَيْكَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ يَبْتَغُونَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ. They seeking the wasila. The wasila is the ways to be the nearest to Allah. قَالَ يَا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَابْتَغُوا إِلَيْهِ. Seek the way to get closer to Him and strive in His sake. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained the wasila in Surah Al-Isra. قَالَ يَبْتَغُونَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ الْوَسِيلَ أَيُّهُمْ أَقْرَبُ. Whom among them is the closest, the nearest to Allah? They seeking and hoping His mercy and fearing His punishment. And when they say He's fearing His punishment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, yeah, that's fine, you have fear. قَالَ لَا إِنَّ عَذَابَ رَبِّكَ كَانَ مَحْذُورًا. The punishment of your Lord need to be fear. The punishment of your Lord need to be someone that he's scared of it and he shield himself from it, because he does not know what is going to happen. You don't know your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why, dear brother, respected sister, as believers in this Ramadan, ask yourself how near you are from Allah. Don't ask how Allah is near to you. Allah is the nearest to you. As a matter of fact, with His knowledge and power, He is nearest to you than your jugular vein. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ. How near are you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That's the true question. And if you want to check yourself, check what make you busy, keep you busy in your whole day. There is a servant woman in past generation, she was making sujood in the night praying. Her master wake up and he was looking, you know, for her in her room, he didn't see her. Then he found out that she's making sujood. Subhanallah, in tears and saying, this is her dua. Allahumma bihubbika iyaya la tu'adhibni. Oh Allah, by the love you have for me, do not punish me. So this sage, like, he gets so mad. How can you say such a thing? How can you be certain that Allah loves you? This is no sense. So when she finished, he told her, how can you say such a thing? بِحُبِّكَ إِيَّهِ. So he went like that, like he's the person who has knowledge, you know. He's the one who has the upper hand. So she looked at him, subhanAllah, and she said, yes, I know. Why? Because he make me to wake up at this time and make sujood to him, and he make you to sleep in this time. قَالَ أَقَامَنِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ سَاجِدَةً وَأَنَامَكَ. This is the difference. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had to wake me up to make sujood to him in this night. And you were sleeping. وَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ سَبَقَنِي بِحُبِّهِ مَا أَحْبَبْتُ. If he didn't love me before, I would not have the ability to love Allah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and she reminded him this ayah, قَالَ اللَّهُ will bring people. He loved them and they love him. And the love, what it means of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is that veneration to Allah, is that humility to Allah, is the obedience to Allah, is to feel good and joyful and happy with the remembrance of Allah, is to defend His deen and His way. That's the meaning of the love of Allah. The love of Allah. And the love of Allah to this servant means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with you. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make easy for your way, for you all the way of the goodness. That's the meaning. Therefore, how can we get nearer to Allah? By implementing the true love to Allah, by have more veneration, by checking ourselves. And you find yourself busy in a thing in the dunya and distracted in the thing of the dunya, that no, truly you are not close to Allah. You are near, you're not near to Allah. So you are obstructing the light of Allah to get to you. You are obstructing the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he is the obstacle to the nearest of Allah is us. And in this Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the ability, all the possibility, all the opportunity to be the nearest to him as he is subhanahu wa ta'ala near to us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَقْرَبُ مَا يَكُونُ الْعَبْدُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِ وَهُوَ السَّجْدُ. The closure that the servant will be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in his side, his sujood. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is closer to his servant, قَالَ فِي جَوْفِ اللَّيْلِ, in the heart of the night. And you are making qiyam in tahajjud every night, so Allah is near to you. Ask yourself, are you near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. Dear brother, respected sister, Ramadan, that we have been asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us life and to reach Ramadan, here you are in Ramadan. And this is an opportunity for all of us, not only to be freed from the hellfire, but to change ourselves, to be greater, to be closer, to be more effective within ourselves, with our families, and in the community of large, with the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just enumerate anything in your mind that you want from this dunya. You'll find it that is far and really is a hardship to get it. Because even the one who has a lot of money, he will seeking more money. And to get that more money, it's hard and it requires time and effort. So as the Prophet ﷺ says, if someone will be given two valleys of gold, he will be seeking to get the third one. So it will not stop. And the only one thing that stops a person from longing to get more is death. He's going to fill his eye with dust, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the grave. So when you think about it, how come someone, he's trying to look forward to get many things in this dunya when they are far and hard to get, and you ignore Allah who has everything and he is the nearest to you? This is exactly what Allah told us in Surah Az-Zumar, how everyone will be remorsing himself. And تقول نفس يا حسرت على ما فات. What a great regret that I wasted this companionship of Allah. I wasted this favor of the nearness of Allah to me. يا حسرة على ما فرطت في جنب الله وإن كنت من الساخرين. I use people mocking. What you're doing? You're praying all day. What is going to help you? It's not going to bring you this. It's not going to make you. No. Yes, the prayer is the one who bring you provision. The prayer who's the one who make you a good person. The prayer who's taking and elevating your high standard. That's the prayer. How someone came to come to near to Allah. It's not magic. It's not something that you need to get a degree for. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the dearest to Allah, the way how you draw yourself near to Him is what He made on you obligatory. What He made obligatory on you? He make Allah the five prayer, the siyam, and you are doing that. Just bring some soul in what you do. Just bring, which is focus. Just bring some soul and you find yourself near to Allah because He already near to you. He's already near to you. قَالَ وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِ يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِرِ. I, my servant, keep himself drawing or herself drawing to me by the extra voluntary action, more prayer, more fasting, more sadaqah, till I will love him. Imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when He loves you, so He make every part of your limb is going to be filled with the light. You're going to see with the way of Allah. You're going to walk with the way of Allah. You're going to even shake your hand or do the transaction. All of it in the way of Allah. قَالَ كُنْتُ سَمَعُهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ وَبَصَرَهُ الَّذِي يُبْصِرُ بِهِ وَيَدُهُ الَّتِي يَبْطِشُ بِهَا وَرِجْلَهُ الَّتِي يَمْشِ بِهَا. You're going to be filled with nur, because when someone is dead and Allah bring you back to life, He make you as a minaret of life. You're going to be an example for others, but some you live, bring that joy and honor to yourself. How come not a believer will be seeking to be near to Allah when He's near to us? And when you are seeking and striving to get to near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are under the protection of Allah. You are under the safety of Allah. Abu Jahl, when he came terrorizing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to stop him from making the sujood, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down an ayah. And they told him, Ya Abu Jahl, why you don't? They call him Abu al-Hakam. Why you don't stop him? Look, he's still keeping making sujood. And he said, look at me. So he wanted to strangle him. When he came close to him, he found, like, subhanAllah, between Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and him, a big ditch filled with fire and giant neck of camels terrorizing. He went back scared and he fell. He said, I saw things that beyond beyond my eyes, beyond my thing. He was so scared. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed in the Quran, قال ليدعو نادية. Let him call all his people in his club. سندعو الزبانية. We're gonna call the guardian of hellfire. كلا لا تطيحه. Don't listen to him. واسجد واقترب. Make sujood and come closer. Where our sujood who help us to come closer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you signs, and I finish with this, who help you really to see how near you are to Allah. But in the same time, He will tell you these signs. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala truly loves you, Allah wants to shower you with His mercy, but you cannot access to the level to be loved by Allah only if you are serious, if you really busy yourself with dhikr of Allah. As we said yesterday, look, in the fact of the dunya, people they say, oh, you like this one is the extreme person, he's praying too much and doing too much. Look, you know, since he becomes like extreme. I told them, who is the extreme? You are watching TV the whole day, that's not extreme. You are listening to the music all day. That's not extreme. You are consulting social media every or the whole day. That's not extreme. You are liking and posting and things. That's not extreme. When a person making dua to Allah and making sujood, he become extreme. أَنَّ تَأْفَكُونَ. How can you really think? When someone, subhanAllah, shopping the whole day, he's not extreme. When he's wasting his time, he's not extreme. When someone, subhanAllah, work day and night without believing that Allah is the Razak, that's not extreme. You come to us and you say, this is extreme. Then check yourself in four moments of your day. The first moment, and when you wake up in the morning, what do you think? What did cross your mind? If it's not Allah, then you are not near to Allah. When you go to bed, what cross your mind? If it's not Allah, then you're not near to Allah. When you start the prayer, what do you think? If it's not Allah, then you're not near to Allah. When there is a difficulty that befall of you, what do you think? The first thing to ask for help, if it's not Allah, then you're not near to Allah. Then let's make our tawbah and inab. Because when you want to go to bed, the last thing you have to praise and to remember is Allah. Then that's the path for Allah to love you. And the hadith, Allahumma anta al-awwal fala ahad qablak shay'un qablak, the hadith that I mentioned of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to say it when he goes to bed sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then when you start the prayer, try to remember Allah. This is how, that's striving. This is the mujahada. We are not perfect. We are not people who are going to say, yeah, we are good people. No, we are all, we have this shortcoming. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Al-Imam As-Saddi, he said, He made you to present for you the tawbah. Where are you in the tawbah? He made you to accept your forgiveness. Where is your forgiveness? He made you to meet Him in your salah. Where is your salah? He made you the sujood to be the closest to Him. Where are you in the sujood? So He's near to you. Are you near to Allah? Ask this yourself a question. Am I near to Allah? Be frank with yourself. And then when you wake up in the morning, if the first thing you're going to think about your business is said, I have a problem. The business will perish. The life will end. Why? Because it's in the hand of Allah. Where are you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? For may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us be near to Him. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us be present with Allah in our salat, in our sujood. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the possibility to make a lot of dua. To make a dua as a way of our planning, our projecting. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to free us from the doom of the hellfire in this blessed month. اللهم اعتق رقابنا من النار يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين اللهم تب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم اعف عنا اللهم اعف عنا وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وأقيم الصلاة يرحمكم الله